try using suction cup. It's really, really cool, it's really stable, and once you will try it, you will never go back. When you're pouring off collodion, do it very, very slowly and very, very evenly. If you're doing fast, you will get collodion ridges. Exposure was 1 minute F45. This was actually my first and last plate of that day, so the first plate I'm developing always horrible. Like this pouring developer on a plate is really, really not how you should do it. I lost a lot of developer, and because I've lost a lot of developer, I also lost a lot of silver with developer, so the density is not as thick as it could be. Okay, plate is developed, but now I need to bring it home where I will redevelop to build up the contrast. How should you do it? Well, easy. You get honey, you dilute it 1 plus 3 with water, you pour honey and water on the plate, leave it for about 2 minutes, and then you put it on the drying rack to dry. So what the honey does, it glues on the sticks on the plate and it prevents the plate get dry. This what you're seeing is the back of the plate, you see how sticky it is. On the front, this is the collodion side, it looks like it's normally dried, but it's actually, it's not dried, it's still wet. You just wash the honey away and you can continue with the process. The solution is 1.5 milliliter of standard tincture of iodine in 50 milliliter of tap water. Have you seen how the tincture lost its color, desaturated completely? That means that the iodine reacted with the silver and the plate becomes again a silver iodine, sensitive to light. So that's why you have to bring it to the daylight or to the bulb, expose it to the light for about a minute, and now we can treat it with a pyro developer and silver. Pyro developer is actually 1 gram of pyro acid, 6 grams of citric acid into 350 milliliter of distilled water. In pyro developer, I put inside silver nitrate, but very little, like 3 drops per 100 milliliter. And with this solution, I'm developing first 6 minutes, and then I'm increasing the dosage to 10 drops per 100 milliliter and continuing. Now this is the second part of the video. Making a prints, starting with carbon prints. What you see here is actually a hardened gelatin, which I took out of the water, which is the most stupid thing you can do. What it does actually, it hardened it, and then when I tried to transfer it to the paper, it just didn't stick. So I ruined the half a day of the work. But if you do a carbon print, that means that you are a very patient person and devoted. Meaning that, you know, in the evening I continue my work as nothing happened. So what you see here is I'm separating the hardened gelatin that was like hardened by light from a soft gelatin that wasn't exposed to light. So now, you know, I'm taking away the temporarily support of the gelatin, and on the bottom there is a final support for the hardened gelatin. This is the advantage of carbon printing. There is no developer, there is no fixer, there is no aggressive chemistry, just hot water, meaning that this is the most archival process ever invented. Another problem, the surface was not completely matte or completely glossy, it was just like half-half, and I really didn't like that. So I just decided to do a high-gloss ferrotyping. Here it is, the final result. It's really high gloss, I really love it. The blacks are much deeper and richer, and the sharpness is just amazing. Because I knew this carbon print will look very much like a silver gelatin print, I left on the top, I left some traces of unhardened gelatin, and any expert will recognize this as a carbon print. Last but not least, albumen print. I never can decide which one to go, you know. With carbon print I love it, but also I love albumen print. It's so soft, it's so different than carbon print. So you know, I always make both versions and then I decide which one is better. Okay, I'm finished. Finally I've made this carbon print. Really, carbon print takes so much time. I mean, like, you know, days are just going by and to make one print. And this is this is albumen print toned with gold, with gold chloride toner. So I'm putting both of these babies on eBay as an auction, starting with 0.99, and I'll set the auction only for 3 days because this weekend I'm going to art fair in Budapest. So hopefully I will sell there something too. So And I was invited to be in a panel. We will talk about how to sell art, and this will be actually my case. So hopefully, you know, eBay don't let me down. You know, I achieved some good figures. You know, and I hope this prints will go for a good money. Thank you very much for watching. And I need to shave. I need to shower. I need to go to bed.